Greetings. For many years I wondered, how could the Antichrist get his forces around the world? And when I would, I just could not imagine communism accomplishing this feat. But watching it happen right now in slow motion is amazing. Consider for a moment Christianity and Mohammedism. There is a fundamental difference. So big, so prominent, it cannot be ignored. Christianity, based on Judaism, believes humans have value. Christians and Jews believe this because man is made in God's image. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, according to our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth." God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. And the prophets continued this wonder, this teaching. Psalms 8:4, "What is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visitest him? Yet you have made him a little lower than God, and you crown him with glory and majesty." Job 7:17, "What is mankind that you make so much of them, that you give them so much attention?" Psalm 144:3, "Lord, what are human beings that you care for them, mere mortals that you think of them?" According to the Bible, the God of the Bible created man in his image and cares for man. God has demonstrated man's value. The Bible's God has demonstrated just how much he loves us. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave the only begotten Son, so that everyone believing in him should not perish, but should have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world that he might judge the world, but that the world might be saved through him." The God of Abraham, revealed in the Christian Bible and Jewish Torah, is a God of love. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, who kills the prophets and stones those sent to her, how often I have longed to gather your children together as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, but you were unwilling. Ruth 2:12, "May the Lord repay you for what you have done. May you be richly rewarded by the Lord, the God of Israel, under whose wings you have come to take refuge." Yahweh God offers refuge to those who seek him, who draw near to him. Acts 7:52, "Was there ever a prophet your ancestors did not persecute? They even killed those who predicted the coming of the Righteous One, the Messiah. And now you have betrayed him and murdered him." Over and over, God showed his love in the face of rejection. 1 John 4:7, "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. The one who does not love does not know God, because God is love." This is the message of the prophets, that God, who is love, was motivated by that love to redeem mankind from sin to himself. Mark 10:45, "For even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life a ransom for many." 1 Timothy 2:6, "Who gave himself as a ransom for all, the testimony given at the proper time." Titus 2:14, "Who gave himself for us to redeem us from every lawless deed and to purify for himself a people for his own possession, zealous for good deeds. This is the Injil, the Gospel, the Good News. Every man, woman, and child has value. This is why Western Christian culture is so tolerant. Islam offers nothing which can compare. Mankind has no value in Islam. This is why Islam uses its young and women as human shields. Islam knows the women and children have more value to the enemies of Islam. It is an irrefutable truth the world now faces. Challenge a Mohammedan. Produce your proof. Show me where the Quran says, "Do not kill." You will typically get the following. Quran 5:32, "If anyone slays a person, it would be as if he slew the whole people. And if anyone saved a life, it would be as if he saved the life of the whole people." Read that again honestly and notice something. If anyone slays a person, it would be as if he slew the whole people. And if anyone saved a life, it would be as if he saved the life of the whole people. That is not a command to not kill. It is only a rationalization, an abstract, conceptual argument. Look further, and you will find that it is not even two Mohammedans. Quran 5:32, the whole ayat. "On that account, we ordained for the children of Israel that if anyone slew a person, unless it be for murder or for spreading mischief in the land, it would be as if he slew the whole people, or if anyone saved a life, it would be as if he saved the life of the whole people." Suddenly you see the deception Islam allows and encourages. This is nothing more than historical rhetoric. Part of the subterfuge that Muhammad is another in the line of Jewish prophets. So how is this a slow-motion invasion? What we see in the world right now is the culture of death invading the culture of life. And Western Christian civilization is incapable of stopping Islam's invasion. The actions necessary to stop it are literally unthinkable to minds framed by Western Christianity. And Christian compassion compels us to love just as God loves us. So do not let anger or rage of human reaction govern your heart and mind. While Islam is evil, God desires to redeem, to save Muslims who honestly seek Him. Yet this, my friends, is how Islam, the religion of the Antichrist, will spread nearly everywhere in these last days. Keep watching, because the curtain is ready to go up on the last act of this show. Come, Lord Jesus, come. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.